everybody. Welcome back to another STEM video. STEM, of course, is science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. And today we're going to be doing some science with chicken embryology. So embryology, of course, is the study of embryos, and chicken embryology is the study of chicken embryos. So we are going to be doing some virtual embryology. So we have an incubator here, and we like to keep our incubator 99.5 degrees Fahrenheit and 65% humidity. Hatching eggs need a very warm environment to hatch, and they need a humid environment as well. So this incubator got plugged in yesterday. It's been prepping overnight. So it's now reached a temperature where we can add our eggs into the incubator. So that's what we're going to do today. So we have some eggs here. Hatching eggs. Here they are, 18 beautiful hatching eggs. So these brownish, tannish ones, these are Buff Orpington eggs. Buff Orpingtons are larger chickens. They are meat birds and they're also very good layers. And then these tiny ones here are from some bantams, and bantams are like half-sized chickens. And these chickens, bantam chickens, are millifluers. So we have about half and half of each, and we are going to pop these into the incubator today. And they are all into the incubator. 18 eggs, some Buff Orpingtons, and some millifluer bantams. So the last thing we need to do is use our dial here on the side to turn on our turning function. So what that means is that this the gray tray in the bottom moves like this every 3 hours. And of course that helps rotate the eggs, because of course an incubator is not a mother hen. If these eggs were on the farm, they would be turned by the mother hen, but because we don't have a mother hen, of course we have to do that manually. So the incubator is going to do it for us, so we will set the turning function on. There we go, it is on, and as you can see our temperature is a little bit low and our humidity is just a little bit low, but that's because I opened the lid and some of that humidity escapes and some of that heat escapes as well, but it should come right back up. And then we also have another little gauge inside of there, just for a little bit more info on how our incubator is doing temperature and humidity wise. Until next time, good night, little eggs. Also, a very special thank you to the Rafferty family. They have the chickens that supplied these eggs for us, so a very special thank you to them. It's candling day. So let's candle some eggs. I think candling day is the most magic day because you get to see an embryo inside the egg. So that's what that little dark spot is a chicken embryo. And it's even moving. Amazing. After candling all 18 eggs, it looks like we have 17 viable out of the 18, which is really, really high, which means that we saw signs of life in 17 out of the 18 eggs, which is really, really exciting. So yeah, we will check in again on day 18. Hey everybody, we've made it to day 18, and on this day, we have taken out the slats that used to be in there, and we've also turned off the turning on our incubator. So on day 18, the chicks are turning around in the shell and starting to poke their little egg tooth, which is on the end of their nose, into the air cell. And they get that deep breath of air, and then they start hatching. So on day 18, here we are. It'll be just a couple more days and we will have chicks, hopefully. Cross your fingers. We also set up the brooder, and the brooder, of course, is where the chicks live after they hatch. So we have the heater here. We'll plug that in soon to get it nice and warm. And we have chicken feed, and we have water in there, and of course, a nice little comfy, cozy bed of pine shavings, but no chicks in there yet. But yeah, starting to get exciting. And after hatch day, this is what we had. Hello, everyone. Hello. If you weren't able to tell, there is 5 little buff Orpingtons and 1 little Millie Fleur Bantam. So we have 6 in total, and they are so cute. It's too early to tell whether they're male or female, but hopefully we'll know in the next few weeks.